Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, my name is Fabhia Sarah Tamtia. I'm from class 3A. In this video, I want to talk about argumentative speech with topic gender equality entitled Woman's Emancipation. This video is for my final days in academic speaking class with Mr. Budi sama Budi as a lecturer. Okay, enjoy my speech everyone. Hello everyone. Previously, I have permission to introduce myself. My name is Fabhia Tamtia, and I'm a student majoring in English department at Sultan Ageng Titayasa University, Serang, Banten. I'm honored to have been given the opportunity to stand before all of you to speak about women's emancipation. First of all, let us give thanks to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala for His blessing, so that we can all live in a healthy and happy state. We don't forget to give salawat and greetings to the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, to his family, relatives, and friends. Ladies and gentlemen, when we hear the word gender equality, we are certainly familiar with the term emancipation. What is emancipation? Some of you may think that it is a move on. The woman usually start to make woman equal to man, or to make woman superior to man. If you think so, let me tell you that emancipation is not about equality between woman and man, or the superiority about woman over man. Emancipation is about giving everyone the opportunity to choose freely. Everyone? Yes, everyone, both women and men. Emancipation is not limited to women. That's because the movement believes that women and men both have the right to make genuine choices in their lives. These choices include choices in their job, their education, their role, and their future. Based on the belief of the ancients, it is wrong for women and men to perform tasks beyond what has been assigned to them. For example, women are prohibited from participating in politics, and men are not manly enough to do household chores. I, myself, had a slightly unpleasant experience exactly 3 months ago when I went to Bogor with my friends and chatted with the person next to me. The young man asked, "Where do you work?" I said, "No, I'm still in college." Then he asked again, "Are you married?" I answered, "Not yet, sir. I want to finish my college first." The young man responded to me by saying, "What are women with higher education for?" Generally, women after graduating from school look for work, get married, follow their husband, and finally take care of the house and children. There are still many negative stereotypes that come to women when a woman can freely choose her path. In her YouTube account, Najwa Shihab once said, "Globally, there are around 2.7 billion women who are legally prohibited from having the same job as a man. In Indonesia, an average out of 100 women who are of productive age, only about 51 to 52 are included in the workforce, compared with men, who reach about 83 people. Even if they work, women are paid less than men. Women only earn 77% of what men earn. However, emancipation abolishes that belief and gave women and men the freedom to choose their role in society. We need to pass for more policies that favor women, not just to adapt to the demands of the times, but to develop everyone's potential. not just to support the economy, but to implement human rights inherent in every individual. Ladies and gentlemen, of course, women's emancipation is not easy to obtain. Emancipation, as we know it today, has also been fought for throughout its history for more than a century. It must be so hard for the people who fight for it, yet it takes a very long time to enforce it. That's why we must thank them by respecting and preserving the emancipation of women. To respect and protect it, we, as youth and women, must respect each other's right. After all, the emancipation of women aims to make us better people who can respect ourselves and others. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the end of my speech. Thank you for the time and attention you have given to me. Hopefully, this speech can shed some light of what women's emancipation is all about. Okay, wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Goodbye. Have a nice day, everyone.